Windows 10 supports more hardware out of the box than any previous version of Windows, making device installation easier than ever. As an example, we'll install a USB printer, although the same procedure applies to any USB device you connect. First, power on the printer, then connect it to a spare USB port on your computer. Windows should detect it and begin loading the device driver, so click the setup icon on the taskbar to view its progress. A driver is the software that Windows needs to communicate with a device, and most drivers are built into Windows or obtainable from Windows Update, so if it's got the correct driver for your printer, it'll load it automatically, after which it's ready to use. If Windows is unable to install your printer, check that your PC is set up to download device drivers automatically. To do that, use the search box on the taskbar to search for Device Install, then select Change Device Installation Settings from the top of the results and make sure it's set to Yes, then click Save Changes if needed. Once you've done that, try reconnecting your device again. If it's still not detected, you can try searching for your printer manually by opening the Start menu and clicking the Settings icon on the lower left, then going to Devices, followed by Printers and Scanners on the left-hand side. From there, click Add a Printer or Scanner at the top to manually search for it. If it's found, Windows should install it automatically like before, if it has the device driver. Otherwise, if it's still not found after a manual search, click the link that says the printer I want isn't listed. If you've got a fairly old model, select the first option, then click Next below to run a deeper search. If Windows is still unable to find it, you can install the device manually by downloading the drivers from the internet. To do that, open your web browser and go to your manufacturer's website. If you're not sure what the web address is, you can search for it instead. Once you've found and loaded the site, follow the Support or Downloads link from the home page to locate the drivers section, then select your country or region if prompted. From there, you should be able to search for your specific device model, although the exact procedure will vary between the manufacturer's websites. Once you've located your exact device, just follow the links to download the driver software, which might take a while depending on its size and the speed of your internet connection. When it's finished, click Open Folder from the download bar below to view the downloaded driver package. If it's been compressed to save space, you'll need to extract it first by going to the Extract tab on the ribbon above, then clicking Extract All, and following the prompts to unpack the files, which might take a few minutes to complete. Once the extraction's finished, you'll have a folder containing all the driver files, so open it up and look for a file called either Setup or Install, whose type is an application. Here's the one we're looking for, so just double-click it to start the installation and follow the prompts to install the driver manually. Note that the exact steps will vary between manufacturers, although the procedure should be similar to this one. Once the installation's complete, just close the driver app to finish up, after which you're all set. To manage your printer once it's installed, switch back to the printer and scanner settings and select your device from the list. For example, if an app's available for it, you can click the link to get the application from the store. This will often include additional settings and functionality for your specific device, so it's worth checking out if one's available for your model. Other things you can do from your device options include opening the print queue so you can see what's waiting to print, as well as pause or cancel documents from it. You can also manage your device settings, where you can do things like set it as the default printer that Windows uses each time you print from an app, which is handy if you have more than one printer installed. You can also print a test page, troubleshoot issues, and also access your print preferences, where you can set various options like paper size, type, and layout. To return to the previous page, click the Back button on the top left corner. Lastly, scroll down the page for a few additional options. For example, you can let Windows manage your default printer, which will set it to the one you used most recently at your current location. You can also download device software over connections with limited data plans, which is common on mobile or cellular networks, although we recommend leaving this off in order to save costs. And that's all there is to it. In the next video, we'll take a look at how to add a network printer, whether it's a wired or wireless device.